Well, we even have more bombshells going off. Thank goodness it is Saturday. Tell me this was not the longest week of your life. As thousands of homes are being invaded by migrants, the news is like, hey, there's nothing to see here. You have women being killed, squatters are now charging rent. And yesterday I tried to go into the Apple store to buy a new phone. They said that they are completely sold out. So I'm asking you this question, what in the Hades is going on? And actually, it's exactly what happened during the Roman Empire. It's the same thing. And everyone stands back and like, I can't believe that this is happening. This is happening. But we have police. We have police that are gonna. No. Okay. Skip the police. We have absolutely no law and order. The market is all in. We can't get any bigger. It is gonna be so epic when this thing goes. There are experts that were able to call the 2000 top, the 2008 top, and they're calling this one a little top, but I mean, it could only fall maybe 70%. So if you're okay with the 70% haircut, I mean, I'm not, because if this thing goes, it all goes. And still, this is the craziest rising wedge I've ever seen in my life. I mean, you have a couple candles that are like, we got you. Hang on, Bravo. We're still here. All you had to do was turn on one line and you could have made all of your digits go up. That's the 200. And we all jumped in right on that candle. Now, I mean, we've been taking profit on the way up. For the most part, we're all out of the S&P 500. It's at the same time that fund managers that missed that run are now all leveraged long. What is the worst that could happen? Well, I'm glad you asked. It happens every time. Like, shoot, we missed this. Do they not have my indicators? Also, do you not have my indicators? Link in the description. Also, if you cannot find the link in the description, you should not be allowed to trade. And don't email me, because I know you email me. But anywho, rather than focusing on the S&P 500 every single day, we do this on this channel. This is Johnson & Johnson, I know, not a proud trade. But as you know, I take their system. I take their system, and then I go, oh, look, so I'll trade your system, and then I'll buy this stuff, which I'm actually going to go into this in this video, talking about what Rome did and debasement, how we are repeating the past to a T, thanks to the elites. Also, I have a chart, thank you to you guys sending me, of who's pulling the strings and how this is going to end. I'll just give you a hint, Rockefeller. Do not worry your little heads about the elites and all the things that they're doing. Just get out there and make 52% in my options watch list. What? That was actually on J&J. Nice, right? So if you would like to know how to do this, whether the market go down, buy put, sell call, or market go up, buy call, sell put, link in the description. I'm feeling generous. Any course you want, today only, 80% off. Well, except for my watch list, unless I squeeze one in on you. Those will never go down in price, never ever, only up. So while everyone looks like this in New York, right? There's just a time where everything's good and then everything crumbles. Like Rome, everyone makes money. It's the Gilded Age, and then it's not. You have articles like Fortune. We are essentially in the new Gilded Age, where you don't have a job, as workers get laid off, CEOs and shareholders gobble up hundreds of billions of profit. And the two things that I tell you on this channel, one, start a business. I don't care if you want to wash a window. And two, you always have to move your money. MM, move money. Actually, it could be three M's, move money momentum, because that's what we do, we're momentum traders. Well, the fuse is lit, right? Ride the rocket. That's what it is. You swings and you're like, hold on for dear life while the entire world blows up. Bravo, you say world blows up, then I see like the stock market going up. But you know, I say blow up and I say, you just wait. We're making money while it's blowing up. I'm going to show you some things that will just blow your mind. When they say our GDP is so good, we are in Great Depression era, if it wasn't for one thing, and it's called math, and this math will catch up to you. Again, get out of the city. When you have 200 billion, I'm just rounding up because Janet will get up there, 200 billion added to the national debt in 20 days. A Citadel CEO warns government spending borderline insanity. So just when you thought the plandemic and what was spent there was insanity, They're just doubling down. Do not be surprised if your taxes don't double. Now, let me come on down here to the corner and explain something. If this was measured by any normal measurement, even like the Great Depression, our GDP, now you guys can do the numbers, you can add for me. I'm going to say we're somewhere between negative 20 and negative 25% GDP. Not this, whoa, GDP's up 2%. No. If you were to take the amount of debt, or AKA money printing, that is in the system that you have to pay back with your taxes, that comes from Janet and she creates a bond, and then your banks use your money to buy said bonds, look at this. US GDP minus US federal debt versus the Wilshire 5000 went down. See, green, Wilshire went up. Hey, I know how we can solve this problem. Let's just create lots of bonds. And I know what you're thinking. Everything's fine. The camel is fine. There will be a final straw. There will be one more that breaks the camel's back. So we will continue to do this until it ends. So basically, it's just hot potato. They're like, oh, Biden, oh, Trump, you got this, Donald. So as they keep propping up GDP, look, 2%, 1%, that's not contraction. The truth is, look at real gross domestic income. This just came out. Percent change from year over year. You see? Recession. Or also known as contraction. And contraction is basically what happens right before the baby comes out. And it is also everything that you are seeing is exactly what happened during the Roman Empire. As the U.S. faces, I mean, time is even given me this one. The same risks ancient Rome faced in Caesar's day. Now, some people will argue, well, it was this straw that broke the camel's back in Rome. No, it was this one. It was this. I went through that thing called university, and I've had everyone tell me just about everything. From monetary policy to total lawlessness. Hey, lawlessness. Since I am a financial channel, I need to explain this. Then I'll go into lawlessness in a second. So if you could hit buttons, all kinds of buttons, the share, like something, because the video I did yesterday, YouTube's like, we don't like you anymore. I think the algorithms now on me, other channels can get away with it. Me, not so much when I'm telling you about these guys that are like, oh, there's a law and we're gonna take over your home. Actually, this guy tried this in Canada. Did not work in Canada, so he came here. And now the whole kit and caboodle are taking over houses in the United States of America. And if you're like, well, I don't remember this guy in Canada, right here. Migrant, influencer, pro-buy, I probably should not use that word. Shoot. Anyways, some dude, let's just say, he's just not doing too well. Probed by child service. Even that, those put those words together. Sorry, as a YouTuber, you're just like, oh, I shouldn't have said that. And admits he tried Canada first, but it didn't give handouts. In America, we don't call it handouts, we call it hand ups. So here he is in Canada, a little less angry. Oh, and by the way, because I say things and I have to back them up with New York Post, they're coming into your houses. And they're taking over. And if you decide to come back or if you're there, they'll kill you. Like how they killed this young lady. Blunt force trauma to the head. Here is the full article, but I'm not going to go into it because YouTube will say that was not comfortable for me to look at because we can't show bad things. We can't show what's going on. Two squatters, who took over NYC home of woman found beaten to death. And the rest. I'm sure they will be found and maybe sent back or told, maybe you misunderstood. You can't do that. Okay, go back. Because we know you have renters. So look at this. Suspected squatter. 1 million New York City home is subletting space in bizarre twists. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of bizarre twists. But in the end, it all burns down in a beautiful dumpster fire brought to you by math. But everyone wants to look the other way and go, well, you know, it's an inverted yield curve. I'm sure it's different this time. And your GDP and everything that you owe and your taxes, it's like, we'll be able to handle it. And I say, oh, no, you won't. We are all going to suffer. Well, that is unless you start businesses, get out of the city and move your money. Now I need to speak to you about said money. Rome did the same thing. They debased their currency just like we did. Now, was this the reason why Rome fell? Well, I'm sure it's one of many. But kind of like how your money is worth something and then it is not. Now, what they would do, I'll grab a coin here, which, oh, they're all over the place now. I'm going to grab the silver one. It's like the cleaning people are like, I'll take that. So anyways, they will take this said silver, like see, silver, and they'll either shave it, right? It's less because the government needs to keep the money, or they'll cut into it. If it is said gold like this, same thing, just chip, 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 chip. Well, oh, you subscribed. Oh, check to see if you've been, or I've already told you to look around. Until there is nothing, just like the dollar. The dollar, you could go, they'd give you I do not have dollars, but you would go to the bank and they would actually, you would take a $20 bill and they're like, well, here's your $20 gold coin and you could switch it. And then in 1971, Tricky Dick said, we're not doing this anymore. So we moved away from a standard, a gold standard. And now, whatever. Basically, you're living in Fugazi Fugazi, where I've said this a million times before, the bank doesn't have anything. And you could walk in and get a loan, $1 trillion, I don't care, out of thin air. They're just praying that you pay it back with interest, and they keep doing this. So there is no money in the vault, your money is not money, but I always beg and plead, please, whatever you do, try, and I have no links for coins or gold or silver in the description. Leave that to my other friends that do that. Try to hold tangible assets and then trade the paper, like GLD. Because at some point, when people go, you know what, I should have that. There's no way you'll be able to, there is no way that you will be able to get this. No, not at all. And you want to know how much this is worth right here? Per GDP, about $72,000. And the cleaning person's like, oh, but the truth is no one understands what money is or value. The same thing, silver and gold. And there's very limited, this is actually a better value. When everything breaks, you won't be able to get this. Actually, look above my head. Well, try to pull it right here so I can touchy. Silver, okay. How about one of these is worth $1,500? I have lots of them. How much was this in 1913? $2. From $2 to $1,500. Wait until it breaks. Because yes, essentially, at least this still, there was something there, right? But we have become Rome, where we have lawlessness, the taxation, the government, like everything. I mean, look at this. This is what one of you guys sent me. But what I want you to see in this cool little chart is the red areas. Now remember, you had the vid. What did it do? It's nice little diagram here. But all it does is weaken society, censorship, partner. Like, I haven't seen that. War on farmers, weaken society, anti-meat, mass migration. Each one of these I've talked about on the channel, and every single one of these the Google doesn't want me to talk about because it has to do with the elites and how they are taking over the entire world piece by piece. Mass migration erodes, right? Erode, weaken society. And then my little forte over here, financial, weaken society. Climate, weaken society. Wealth transfer. I don't know, am I a boy or am I a girl? Weaken society. Until they finally pull the rug and then it is all gonna go. And you got a taste of it 3 years ago. You want to know how many people fought back? None. I know, because I would drive to the beach. I'd go around. I'd do things. I'd go into Costco doing the things that they told me not to do. It's like, wow, they're really lockstep on this one. That gave me a huge, you know, it was like when I tell you about make sure you have gold, make sure you have physicals, gold and silver, and then all of a sudden something happens. I'm like, wow, this thing's going quick. Kind of like Bitcoin. It's, you know, you're kind of complacent. I'll just wait to the next dip and then maybe I'll pick some up. I'll just wait until all the banks start failing because Johnny Bravo will tell me. But what you need to know, it happens in a blink of an eye. Right now, I am seeing stuff. Large U.S. banks suffer another weekly deposit outflow, stocks and Fed reserves completely decouple. That doesn't mean panic. That just means do something. Start businesses, move money. And that's why I give you today, right? Whichever one you want, 80% off. Do the crypto one too. I've easily spotted this and been like any crypto YouTuber and made truckloads. I know these guys because they make millions because they go, oh, this is a rising wedge. The nine count comes on, purple nurple. What's going to happen? It's going to break. It broke. This is a falling wedge. That's bullish. It's going to break up. Not too much, but it did. But on the swing trade, you're still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 candles under the Bravo 9, still moving down. Make sure that is when everything gets cut in half. Make sure you get it by here, that lineup for a long time. And if I had to get, I'd say accumulate at 50, accumulate down here at 41, then accumulate down here in the 28 when it went above the 200-day moving average. Do you see the importance of understanding just a few lines? Anywho, the fuse is lit, and hopefully I put a little fire under your boo-ha-ha to do something, but you know what that do something is, and I love you. Thank you for hanging out with me. Whenever you can, I appreciate you, and all your comments, I look at it, I heart it, I take it to heart, and I will see you tomorrow.